Hello everyone, welcome to Analog IAS. In this new video on 3-minute series for prelims, we'll be discussing about the Charter Act of 1813. The Charter Act is the first in the series that has been established in the year 1813. The other two acts are Charter Act of 1833 and the Charter Act of 1861. After that we get the Councils Act. Now, the main purpose of enacting this act by the British Parliament was due to the Napoleon Bonaparte's continental system in Europe. This system prohibited the import of British goods into French allies in Europe, leading to huge losses for the merchants and British traders. Therefore, the British traders and merchants demanded that they be given a share in the British trade in Asia, particularly India. Therefore, dissolving or restricting the monopoly of the English East India Company, which they had the sole trading rights. Therefore, the government, the British government, did not yield to this demands by the English traders completely. Rather, the British merchants were given permission to trade in India, but the trade with China and also the tea trade in India has been completely reserved for the East India Company. And these two provisions are provided through the Charter Act of 1813. Some of the other provisions of the Charter Act are: it asserted the Crown's sovereignty over the British possessions in India, and the company's rule and the trade monopoly in India that we have just discussed, that is the tea trade in India and also the trade with China, has been extended for another 20 years. It also empowered, that is the Act also empowered the local governments to tax the people, subjected to the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court, which was established through the Regulating Act of 1773. The Act also gave more powers for the courts in India over the European British subjects as well. And the Act for the first time granted permission to the missionaries to come to India and engage in the religious proselytization. And this is the first important step taken by the British Parliament towards education, where the company was to take up the greater role in the education of the Indians under them. That is, it also allocated a grant of 1 lakh rupees per annum for the purpose of education in India. Now let us solve this question. Consider the following statements regarding Charter Act of 1813. The Act provided rupees 10 lakhs for the purpose of education in India. Monopoly of East India Company was restricted completely. The correct answer is D, none. As we have just discussed, that the Charter Act provided 1 lakh of rupees for the purpose of education and not 10 lakhs. Therefore, statement 1 is wrong. The monopoly of East India Company was not restricted completely. Rather, it has maintained its own monopoly in the tea trade in India and also the trade with China. Therefore, the correct answer is D, none. Thank you.